Oh, how the time flies. I cannot believe that. I just sorted in their places the supplies from the previous box, and the new Scrawlr box is on my table already. So let's open it up and see what we got this month. And I'm already loving it. I love the color combination. And what you see me doing here, I am weighing the packet, because Scrawlr box usually has paints in one box, pencils or markers in another, and then paints again. So this month should be paints, but the packet was quite light, so I'm guessing no paints. So this month's box is designed by art by Safana. Gorgeous colors. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And we are starting with a little magazine, which includes interview with an artist, a description of the products, artwork created by the subscribers from the supplies in the previous boxes. Do excuse the moment of vanity, I was checking if they have included my creation also. No. So let's move on. And the first thing in the box is this paper pad, which is interestingly called cartridge paper. Never heard of it. It looks like a designer paper, paper for drawing, paper for colored pencils. It is quite a generous pad. 16 sheets of 120 gram paper. And I will need to do a homework and research what does cartridge paper mean exactly. Because obviously it's not a printer paper. And let's open the packet! And let's see what's hiding under the layers of tissue paper. And it is this month's... Oh! ScrawlrBox has been cheeky this month. There is another packet within the packet. So the intrigue continues. Let me remove the tissue paper. And we'll start with the monthly sticker. And the candy. Love this candy. A lot of people are snarky about the inclusion of this candy, but ScrawlrBox does pay attention to detail, and candy always corresponds to the colors of the box. So I like this nice touch. And there is a little bottle. We've never had bottles before, right? And this one is called liquid pencil. So this seems to be the theme of this month's box, at least for me. It shows how little I know about art supplies. Never heard about liquid pencils, don't know what it is, don't know how to use it, so we'll be learning it, and I'm quite excited about the fact that there are things that I don't know and that there are things that I will discover. I'm battling with the bottle a little bit, couldn't open it, so let's leave it for the moment. There is a brush, no description on the brush what it is and the size. There is a black liner from Derwent, always useful. And let's start swatching them too. So I will remove the box, open our cartridge paper pad, and let's see what they do. Yes, I will be a little bit patient with the mystery packet. So this is a black liner by Derwent. The company name doesn't require any commentary. Decent black liner. I'm putting the little bottle aside for the moment and grabbing the mystery packet. But that little bottle doesn't leave me alone. So I want to know what it is, and I'm reading the little tag which describes the products, and all it says is that this is a product that can be used as a highlighter, and it is designed by the artist who designed this box, so it must be something good. The liquid white pencil is made by none other than the featured artist herself, Safana. It is perfect for adding highlighting and layering effects to your work. But it doesn't say how to use it. And in addition to that, I was trying to open the bottle and I couldn't get it open. I felt that it must be a dropper because there is this squidgy part on the top of the bottle. And then I decided that I even will open the little magazine and will read. But also there is nothing more than just the text that this is supposed to be a highlighter. But how to use it? So I will figure it out later. Let's open the packet finally. It has been wrapped very carefully. And when I got this far, I noticed that there is... The sticker says Posca pencils. And this is where I got really excited. We all know Posca company. I love colored pencils. And indeed, those are colored pencils. Did you know that Posca does colored pencils? I didn't know that. And later I read that this is a fairly new product. And I am so happy and excited. I can't wait to try these. We all know, if you are in mixed media, you probably have a huge collection of Posca acrylic paint pens. I have black and whites, not colored ones. But these are pencils. So I hope you share my excitement. Let's try them out. So this is the first one. It is lilac. And it is really pigmented. I am barely touching the paper. Even here where I go over the second time. And the pigment comes off so easily and so softly. Noticing that Posca has used quite humble color names. Simple lilacs, grays, no fancy ocean song in the sunset thing. Just ordinary factual names. This is blue-green, for example. But here I notice something else. The only place on the pencil where you can see its color name and number is on this little barcode sticker, and it is located right at the beginning of the pencil. So if you use a pencil a lot, already after 1/3 into the pencil, you have to note that you need to get a new one. Or swatching the pencils is absolutely necessary to be able to buy the color you are running out of. So two more colors, and I'm still happy about how they lay down. So soft, so smooth. True joy to work with them. So the last three colors were blue, yes, simply blue, fuchsia and light orange. Cannot wait to see how they perform, so let me draw something and show you the result. And this is what I drew. The prompt was to paint something secret garden themed. So I drew and colored this bug, and I even managed to use the liquid pencil. See the highlight on the eyes? And I used finger to smudge a little bit of this white liquid to indicate the highlight. And I'm very, very happy about these pencils. I was layering 5, 6, even 7 layers of color, and they were still keeping layering. Wonderful. And yes, now I want to get a bigger set of these Posca pencils. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing. I hope you enjoyed the products. See you soon. Bye.